I'm Ashley Stewart, and I am from Newton Moore Senior High School in Bunbury, and I teach engineering, science, and mathematics. Newton Moore is a science specialist school as well as a specialist engineering school. From year 7, they're actually starting to have an engineering course offered throughout. So they'll be split into two streams starting in year 8, where they have the engineering specialist course and the science horizon specialist course. So with the engineering course, they'll be doing the same mathematics, but they'll be doing it in with relation to what engineers do. So, you know, you need to learn about volume, about different types of capacities, and learning how to do algebraic calculations. And it's important from the beginning all the way up until year 12. The reason why it's not squared is because it's circumference. Remember, the circumference of a circle is just pi times 2 times r, or pi times d. That's the difference with the area. The area is pi r squared. The mathematics that we use is hugely important to what engineers do later in the future, especially in the year 11 and 12 courses where they learn integrals and derivatives, when they're learning area under a curve and things like that. My husband's an engineer and he still uses that stuff now, so it's good that the kids know that they're using it from high school all the way up until they, you know, they graduate from uni and they actually become engineers. So now we're finding surface area. Surface area, what's the difference between surface area and volume? Yes. Yes. So surface area is the area of all the surfaces on the outside, and the volume is how much is inside. So when they come into year 7, they do an introduction to engineering. So they learn about a variety of different types of engineers, like chemical engineers, materials engineers, structural engineers, a variety of things that they learn. And they do a variety of different projects. So they'll build bridges or build model rockets or build, we built Mars rovers last year as well, where they had to put an egg to make sure it dropped and it, you know, nobody died in the process.
Last year and this year, I have been involved in the engineering program, where we have got to use in our own time at lunch and recess robots like the Eddie here, who are specialised robots that allow us to further our knowledge in engineering, as well as NXT kits and other wonderful innovations.
One of our year 10 projects that we do is just a little buzzer game. They use the soldering irons to actually complete the circuits that they put in the back of the box here. And when you turn it on, it's like a little game that they can play where if they touch it, it buzzes. But that's a year 10 project that we do, which involves the soldering irons, which leads them into their year 11 and 12 projects that includes a lot of soldering iron and more Dremel work. And then our year 11s and 12s do electronics engineering as well, because that's the engineering studies course that we offer. And they build sumo bots. They'll be building mechanical lolly sorters next semester, where they sort them by color. And that's through a programming system that we have that they'll do. So in our year 11 course, this semester we built sumo robots. We used the pickaxe logicator program to actually program this guy to make him do things we want him to do. So as a sumo bot does, they're in the little ring, and we've programmed this to go forward. When it hits the black, it'll turn back around, and then it's against another robot. And once they hit each other in the arm, then it wobbles a little bit and it turns off. So these sumo bots, everything made on it besides, you know, your batteries and your wheels and everything, are made by hand. So our PCBs, we actually make them, and all the component holes, we have to drill them. So we use our Dremel to drill the holes in our PCBs to connect all the components. And everything you see on here was done by hand by the students. Even the gluing this on, all the parts, switches, everything was done by hand.
So now we're gonna look at the perimeter of a semicircle, which would be closest to. So this you're gonna have to use a little bit of rounding. When you're finding the perimeter of the semicircle, you guys use the right equation to find the arc length, but you also have to use that 7 for the perimeter. So the arc length you found was correct, then add the 7, and that's what you would have gotten 18 with.
In the engineering course that we teach at 11 and 12, they have to take a core engineering studies. And in the core engineering studies, they learn about materials, which is a chemistry base. Then they also learn about how materials can be shaped and molded, and their volumes and their capacity. So they need to be able to calculate the volume that a certain material will hold in order to transport or to maintain a certain substance that it has in it. And that's, they learn it starting in, you know, basics in year 7 and 8. In year 9 today, we were learning about volume and capacity and area, surface area as well, which translates into the core engineering stuff that we do in year 11 and 12.
So let's find the surface area of this triangular prism. So how many surfaces does that triangular prism have?
Five.
5. So you're going to have to find the surface, the area of each one of those 5.
In my year 10, 11, and 12 classes, I have all boys, which is a bit disappointing. You'd like to see more girls in the engineering classes, and being an engineering specialist school, we're hoping to see more girls enrolling in the course over the next few years. But what's good to see is that we have all these boys who are really engaged in a subject, using hands-on work and really enjoying what they're doing. They also work together when they have come across a problem, when they're sumo bots, somebody else has come across the problem, and they work together to solve the problem or evaluate the issue and then come up with a solution together, and it's really good to see that type of collaboration in a classroom.